Yes, you talked about how we should hold leaders accountable. We should hold, those in authority, those whom we call elite, especially those we've put in public office, we should hold them accountable. The question is, how do we hold them accountable?
It commences. Thank God we are going to have elections soon. We are watching. Nigerians are watching. We're not fools anymore. The truth of the matter is that the Chibok issue, right, has thrown up a lot. And if we were sleeping all the while and the enemy crept in, well, we are awake now. We will look for a way to push them out. I think it's redefining our consciousness as a people. And at this moment, this will be one of those moments to also that one should also call on the authority at the federal level to ensure that people don't make utterances and get away, especially the ones that heat up the polity and get away with them. People should be queried. They should explain if they have made statements and they think they are misquoted or quoted out of context. They should be called to order and they should retract whatever statements made and all of that. And then this is also that moment to stop politicizing security issue in Nigeria. People should realize that security involves everybody. Everybody, both the market woman and that little boy out there on the street that is going to harass you to clean up your wiper when your wiper is actually not dirty and all of that. Everybody should be educated how to get involved in developing and indeed securing our environment.
Let's take it from that perspective of education. Are you seeing that already? Are you seeing that across board? Are you getting the feeling that that education is coming across? Because if you ask those whom we should ask in terms of those who should get the message across, they will tell you that they are doing their jobs. But do you feel that? Do you have that feeling?
A bit of consciousness is coming up now. A bit of more of the consciousness is coming up now. But a lot more needs to
What do you
be done.
want to see?
I want to see that at the primary level, that kids are informed, it's included in either in our curriculum or whatever it would, however it is that it will be structured, that from the primary level, people, those kids are taught how to understand what to see that shouldn't be in the environment. Do you understand me? And then at the tertiary level, beyond waiting for when you graduate, you go for National Youth Service, I think that consciousness should commence at that level, where we teach our people. Cultism and all of that at the tertiary level, even at secondary level, is there now. These things should be discouraged. And the issue of education, really, I think it involves, at this time, family as well. The family unit is very, very key. Because I didn't have to be educated to see that my child is doing wrong or going through
Chimelington,
the
just
wrong
before
track.
you quip in, you are a filmmaker. That's what you do as
Yes,
a
ma'am.
professional. Do you think that your industry also has a role to play here?
We have gotten involved, fully. We have gotten involved. Television is like a mind bender. As a matter of fact, I could come to this platform to talk today because I feel sincerely that that medium is being ignored. We commenced with telling our stories, the rum and ballo kind of story. We've gone beyond that. We're now getting to that level where we want to discuss national and international issues. I commenced a film project called Child Soldier in 2008, right? I did thorough research on what it is, what the danger in ignoring these children who probably may have been involved in conflict one way or the other. Especially also, like when I commenced the research and all of that, people were asking, do we have child soldiers in Nigeria? And I said, yes. During the Civil War, we had kids who were recruited both by government and also the rebel groups. And eventually, the war ended. Nobody made moves to rehabilitate or reintegrate them to the society and all of it. So the motion picture practitioners have gotten involved. And indeed, that's why I say that everybody needs to, realize that this is our war. If certain things have been done at federal level, it should be replicated to even local level. The government at the federal level has embraced Nollywood practitioners. But at state levels, no. Local levels, no. People are not being encouraged to get involved, you understand me, directly in using motion picture, which is, if you ask me, the next thing that should, tackle some of the vices that we have been faced with in Nigeria. This medium should be embraced differently now, should be seen as just a group of talented people expressing themselves. It's gone beyond that. One, it is business. Secondly, it is good in the area of propagating whatever visions and views we have and dreams we have for Fatherland. Because Nollywood should be replicated as Hollywood is to America. That's my personal view, sincerely.
Okay.
We should be engaged, And it's not enough to celebrate superstars. When we discuss Nollywood, most of the time when we see with superstars, you conclude that you've met Nollywood. No, there are people who are captains of the industry. There are people who write the scripts. There are people who ensure that the content that goes out there comes out very well. But we, back home here, when it comes to celebrating entertainers, it is those that you see in front of the camera. And all of this is not very important.
Tell us if you can. Tell us if you can. I mean, did you get to get the perspective from your late brother, may he rest in peace, about this war on insurgency?
This war?
Yeah, did you get
his views? From the military, yes, my view. My view from the interaction I had with him, right? What I deduced from the interaction is simple, that first, I think our military had been compromised a long time ago. They had allowed politics to creep into the military environment. They had allowed tribal sentiments and religious sentiments creep into that environment. I think a lot of overhauling needs to be done in that area. That's my sincere view from what discussion that I had with him. And another is that I think people are indeed not encouraged, right? People are not encouraged. When a military man dies in this country, how do we celebrate him or her? Do we just bury them like chicken? They shouldn't. They should be buried like heroes that they are. They must be encouraged to understand that they have done that, that if you do, you know, over there in America, during the campaign of Barack Obama and McCain, McCain's strength was that I had lost an arm for America fighting as a military man. For them, that was a huge sacrifice over there. But here, do we have that?
Is this still the same?
I think it's still the same because America celebrates their military, and that is where I think we need to do more. Really, we need to do more in that area.
All right, we'll have to let it go here. Dixon Rigby is a public affairs analyst and also a filmmaker. Thank you for coming on this morning.
Pleasure.
We'll be back in just a moment here. Join us again. Welcome back. Well, this is where we draw the curtains again today on the program. As always, we thank you for watching. We'll see you next time. I'm Chamberlain Osong.
Thank you. I'm Malwe Ogun.
Well, many thanks. I'm Swayman Alede. See you again.